Institute, Allahabad. He got his master's and PhD from IIT Kharagpur, and he has served for 39 years in ICAR, and he has got several personal awards to his credit. And he is a fellow of Academy of Agriculture Sciences, Rafi Ahmad Kidwi Award, Basant Rao Naik Award, like so many. He's got also 12 best paper awards by various institutions. He has got 142 research papers and 16 books published, 205, I think he's well known. I would request Dr. Manoj, if you can tell a few words about him, and Dr. Professor Singh.
Thanks, Professor Sayyed. It's my honor, actually, just to say a few words for that. And I learned a lot, actually. I joined his work or his project quite late. I was only knowing in my early stages of my career that he is Dr. R.C. Srivastava. He's a very good scientist in soil and water engineering and all those things. I have read so many things about him. But fortunately, we worked together in one of the projects funded by Ministry of Agriculture, particularly on climate change adaptation in vulnerable regions near Delhi in Muzaffarnagar district. We worked together for a couple of years, and I learned a lot, in fact. And from that onwards, I am following him, and really, he is one of the idol from my side, and I really respect him, and it's my honor to introduce him. Thank you, Professor Sayyed. That's what I want to say. I think so. He doesn't need introduction among all agriculture engineering community.
Okay, Dr. Srivastava.
Yeah. Please. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for all of you for giving such a nice introduction. It's all because of my colleagues, my friends, my juniors, seniors, that whatever I could learn and try to evolve the things as it went off. Major work of area was water harvesting. Later on, I came in the groundwater management very late, in only this decade. And then was when we had Dr. Madhus told, when we were working together at Muzaffarnagar. So when we talk of aquifer, we all talk aquifer in terms of equations. Most of the people get how you are going to do about the aquifer. You will talk about the differential equation, deal with the porous media and well hydraulics. But today I will not be talking about those equations, solving few differential equations and all that. I'll be talking about aquifer in a totally layman language. What a layman thinks of aquifer. For him, it is a storage of water from where he can pump at his will if he has got a water extraction equipment, whether powered by diesel, powered by electricity, or powered by solar. And we define it in different way. We define an aquifer, it is unconfined, confined, purged, or some few other names. So, when a person, a layman is interested talking about the aquifer, he's only interested in that whether he can get a reliable water supply for his household or for his farm. He is very little bothered about the wastage of this irrigation water. Most of the time we talk about wasting the irrigation, wasting the this wastage, reducing the wastage. In terms of, if the price becomes more, he will make the less wastage. But as we all know, that this consumer, whether be it a urban dweller or be it a farmer, he will arm twist the whole system to the vote bank, the strength which is available to him in a democracy. He's not interested, maybe even least interested, in recharging his aquifer as he feels that it is his property, whatever it is down the earth, it is his property, it is his will, he can pump it as much as want. He will push for augmenting his water supply from river flows, flowing even from the far off places. We can see all over the country the situation in the Karnataka, it is the Kaveri water which is being diverted to the major areas. In Delhi, it is the not only the Yamuna but from the Ganga, and that also far off from the Tehri. We are doing by pipes and canals, and we never bother about the, till now we are not bothering, now the things have been changed. That what is the right of the people who are basically the user of that water, or what is the ecosystem requirement of, environmental requirement of that water? We are not bothering. But the only thing we think of that this particular area needs water and we have to sink it. The same is happening with the tanker. The tanker industry has grown like anything. They are pumping the water from the nearby villages and supplied to the high-rise buildings. And in my opinion, this works rob the Peter and pay to the Paul. Now, so let us have a different view for aquifer. Can we treat aquifer as a bank account in which deposit has been made by our ancestors? This ancestor word I am using because if I remember a few years back, there was a very huge glee that we have found aquifer near Ghaziabad, which is at the depth of 3,000 feet. And that is just very good quality water. But that water was never deposited by us. It was deposited by ancestor. We don't know at what time that water reached to that depth. So now if you treat as a bank account in which we are withdrawing the money every year, every time, and then depositing the money in that. Now if we are withdrawing more money and depositing less, what will happen? The account will deplete. So if we are, there are three conditions which we can think of. Either go on withdrawing that money from the account and keep on spending. That's like selling the family silver to run your daily account, daily expenditure. Or we increase the efficiency, reduce our expenditure by increasing the efficiency, or increase our income so that we deposit more and it balances with our expenditure. Now, we have to treat the aquifer in the same pattern, and that's why I have used the water positive word, that no, the balance should always remain the positive. Now, how to do it? Let us start with first thing, that reduce use of water by enhancing the efficiency. But there we don't have any incentive for any urban dweller that you use it more efficiently. Efficiently, you will have to pay less, or you will get a more reliable water supply. Because the problem is that if X is doing it and his neighbor is not doing it, but both will get the same benefit. So it's not that the Y his neighbor gets incentive, since both will either get incentive or not get incentive. So X feels he is being de-incentivized, and so since he stops doing that. Once I was talking to a group in the seminar organized by CII, and I said, if we just think that how the water is being used in the toilets, most of the time flushing is done only after someone goes for the urination. Now we don't have design of our toilet, our system, that if you one has used only for the urination, the water required, the flushing is done only by some 250 ml of the water or the 500 ml of the water. The water use is same whether you go for the urination or you go for the latrine. So, can you, but that will require more investment by the user, and he has got no incentive to spend another 1,000 rupees to make it a double chambered. So, we have to see how we can increase this. Similar for the farmer. Now, the farmers are using this flexible pipes, or even these pipes, mainly underground pipes, which we found very useful when we were working for the Muzaffarnagar, that no farmer is very much interested in using those underground pipes. They immediately went agog with that they have got additional land available after demolishing their open channels. So, we have to incentivize that they increase the efficiency. Second is, increase the recharge. And third is, use wastewater. Now, I calculated just that if and there is a, why we can't make it one administrative unit, whether be it a village or be it a block or be it a small town, that no, you will be able to use only that much water what you produce. If you're not using it properly, you will be getting only this much water. Now it is up to you. You use it efficiently or just be an inefficient user and get the less amount of water. I just calculated that if an area of 100 square kilometer with a population density of 5,000 per square kilometer has got 5 less population, then its average expenditure, which I have gone a bit higher side, will be anything between 80 crore to 100 crore liters annually. Now, how much a charge a 100 square kilometer will do? I made a small calculation, and that comes from about it is recharge, natural recharge is just 10 crore liters. It creates around, if it is using 100 crore liter of the water, it will be producing around 50 crore liter of the wastewater. How much rainfall it is getting? Suppose it is getting an 800 millimeter rainfall, so it is getting around 80 crore liter of the rainfall. With a city having 60% paved area, it will get around 40 crore liter, 50 crore liter runoff every year. How much we are recharging? Artificial recharge. If you recharge even 50% of that 60%, it comes around about 30 crore of liters. And rest, and then about the 50 crore of the wastewater. So we can easily do it. That this 50 wastewater, a part of it, let it be used, so we are reducing the use on that side. We increase the efficiency, we will be reducing again there. And the rest wastewater, if we treat it, filter it properly, and transport it to the nearby villages, where it will be taken very nicely by the people, because they will be getting a nutrient-rich water. So, then you take out the good quality groundwater from that village. Let us make it a barter. That no, you provide treated wastewater to the village for the irrigation. Then only you will be getting good quality groundwater from there, or even the water from their rivers. Why? We, urban area, should get all the take out all the water because they have got the money, and without using this. So my idea is now, what with my team is working on it, to develop recharge structures, which we have developed one very good recharge structure where we are filtering it and recharging it. Recharging the groundwater, we are getting at present around 6 liters per second, but we are planning to increase its capacity to the 20 liters per second easily by making it more inlet water more. Then we have got the, we have developed the filter for the wastewater treatment. And that wastewater treatment we are doing not only the pumping it, but also in the in-situ also we are developing that technology. And then micro irrigation, which Dr. Tiwari will be talking about after that, micro irrigation is another. So combining these three, I am telling that if we go to a village, irrigate the whole village, utilize all the wastewater which is coming from there, and make it a water positive. Can we make it? This is all what I wanted to talk, because this is an area which I feel we agriculture engineers have got a future in investing in the, both our research efforts, both our teaching efforts. As I was talking, that we are planning even for a PG diploma in the wastewater management, waste management. Not only the wastewater will be a part of it. Can we go on increasing the wastewater use and make a policy? But I am more interested in making a policy where any administrative unit, be it a village, be it a block, be it a district, be it a municipality, that will have had to be water positive. You can't withdraw water more than what you are having. As I said, in a family, in a bank account, you just can't survive by selling the family silver, because that will never be sustainable. So what I am thinking, that let us talk about this, that no, we will be using water in such a fashion so that whatever we are recharging, whatever rainfall we are getting, that will be recharged. Part of it will be recharged totally. Our recharge systems have to be, now the problem will come up in mainly recharge. Let me talk a bit about the recharge system. A good number, we got some systems designed where we had sand and pebbles, stones and all that. And what was reported that every year that has to be cleaned. I talk like this, that if we have to clean it every year, do you think that it will become sustainable? They said, it is just 9 cubic meter of the material. I told them, have you any idea how much 9 cubic meter means? I told, one truck load of sand which comes to us is just 6 cubic meter. That means it is almost 1.5 truck load of the material of the sand or of the gravel combined. So when you are combining sand and gravel, 1.5 truck load, you have to take it out from that pit. Put the water over it to wash it, all the silt which has been deposited, and again recycle, refill that pit. I doubt that any farmer is going to do that. And we have to be very careful that how this water which we are recharging should not have any impurity. Its turbidity should be within the limit. So that, because if we send the turbid water in that aquifer, it is going to go. So we have to design the filters, whether filters be of any type, but it has to be filtered properly. Last year when the monsoon, I saw one well in the Haryana, they had opened the well and the whole water of the field was going in the aquifer, so that he was very happy. If some channels run it, what a good, nice way of recharging the aquifer. But then where you are sending turbid water along with all the impurities of the fertilizer, pesticide in the aquifer. So we have to be very careful that what sort of the recharge structure we are designing and how it is recharging. Similarly, for the wastewater, how much wastewater, where to use it. Now we are doing another one. I will like to share my experience. I said, how to do it in our own campus. I will just, like I was just missing that. I did this for my campus. I asked my engineers how much water we are using, how much it is being recharged, how much you are using for the domestic purpose, how much we are using for the irrigation. He came out he told, sir, we are using 228 hectare meter of the water annually. This much is the water which we are pumping. Out of which, 110 crore liter. I said, I think 228 crore liter. 110 crore liter we are using for our domestic purpose. And 118 crore liter coming as a our irrigation. How much we are recharging? We are recharging just 120 crore liter. That means every year we are withdrawing 100 crore liter, 110 crore liter more almost from the aquifer. That I was talking about that and the silver. So now we are planning that now we will be recycling our new area which is going to bring under the irrigation that has to be from the wastewater. One of the reasons the wastewater contains such a well which we don't want to come in the food chain. I told, and there was a pressure on me to have the fodder seed production, especially the fodder grasses. I said, suppose we irrigate, let us study this. Suppose we irrigate fodder grasses for the seed production by this wastewater. The whatever the wastewater, the heavy metal, let us test, will get deposited in the seeds of the fodder. But the harvest index of the forest, this fodder grasses will be too low. So very little amount will get in the seed. Now, if we use this seed for the fodder production next year, what will happen? A very little that will got spread over the whole biomass. And but the first year where we are using the state wastewater, we will not be using that fodder for the consumption of the animals. We will instead send it to this your vermicomposting, composting business. So this what we can think of such line that no, we will not allow this to come in the food chain. We will allow to grow for the timbers. We are doing it on for our revenue for plantation also, same thing. That no, will not allow, so we will use the wastewater for irrigation, but will not allow it to come in the food chain in any way. So can we do like this and then utilize that water? Use that water for the recycling wherever possible and then water it for the good quality groundwater by reducing the irrigation requirement of the village. So we are getting a village irrigated. We are getting the groundwater, good quality groundwater for the municipality. We have to combine this business together, both intertwined. Not that a municipality wants the water, so go on bringing the water from the outside and never bother about the recharge. Let the municipality know that if they are spending 100 crore liters, they have to recycle a part, at least 60% of their wastewater. And they have to recharge the water, whatever there was, so, and that will also reduce the water logging. But we are working on it in Bihar, in our North Bihar, which is very prone to the water logging, that if we are able to send this water in the aquifer, we will be able to reduce a bit of water logging also from the area of the villages. So we are working on this. We hope to come out with the this data. I have not been talking about any question, any Dr. Ismail had sent me a message, if you have got any presentation to do. I said, well, I will be talking mainly extempore. A few things I might have been missing, but what that was my feeling, that if we want our water scenario to remain sustainable, stable, we have to do so that so I will try to end like to end it here, and I will be happy to receive the questions if any.
Will you be able to take one township, Dr. Srivastava?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Come a town nearby, and then do this. If the government, I think you can convince the government to do as a pilot project. No.
I tried to talk to the this your town development minister who belongs to the nearby district, which is most prone, that town is most prone to the water logging. I always try to avoid during the monsoon month to that town because almost half of the town is under the water. But listen, just that is the problem with the water. They will be very happy if you say that you will be bringing water from source and such a river. That is the problem. It has to be a citizen movement, not by the politicians.
But then the students are the best people to start a citizens movement.
Yeah. Oh, I am trying to start with one village that I have already sanctioned, in the process of sanctioning a project of a few lakhs, so that we will start with a village, make it a water positive, and another water positive is I am going to make my campus. The campus is 1200 acres big, so it is big campus, not a small one. 1200 acres. So I want to make it totally water positive. We hope that in a year or so we will be able to do that. Although you see, sir, even in this campus, I'm facing resistance. अरे साहब आप पानी के लिए भी पैसे देने पड़ेंगे. मैंने कहा जो पानी जिसके जो लोग अपना लॉन इरिगेट करते हैं, जिनके जो ग्राउंड फ्लोर पर रहते हैं टावर में या जिनके पास बंगले हैं, अगर आपने पानी वैसे आपके यहाँ पानी बहता हुआ पाया गया तो आपको फाइन कर दिया जाएगा. एंड आई फाउंड देयर वाज अ ह्यूज मर्मरिंग इन द होल कैंपस कि साहब आप पानी के लिए भी पैसे देने पड़ेंगे, पानी के लिए भी जुर्माना देना पड़ेगा. तो दैट कैन बी अ कंडीशन इन अ यूनिवर्सिटी कैंपस. आई डोंट नो व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन यू गो फॉर अ टोटली डाइवर्स पॉपुलेशन.
नाउ योर करिकुलम रिक्वायर्स स्टूडेंट्स टू बी इन विलेज फॉर अप टू 6 मंथ्स एंड ऑल काइंड ऑफ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज देयर. If you develop these as a projects and let these students work, I think that will be one good way to start. No?
Yeah, that we are thinking over it, that how we can involve the students in our wastewater management. One waste management we are involving. In waste management, I would like to inform that there are two major temples nearby. One is Baba Dham, that is Devghar temple, a well-known to most of us. And another one temple in the nearby town of Muzaffarpur. We are collecting in both places. We are both are the large temples. So a lot of flowers, bilpatra offered every day. So
we are daily collecting.
Please, everybody, mute your cameras. Sorry, speakers other than the speakers. Everybody, mute, please. Thank you. Go ahead, please.
So what we have done, we have put up
wait a minute. I think I'll just mute all of them and again do it. People are unmuting. Dr. Srivastava, can you unmute your?
Yeah, I have unmuted. Yeah.
Thank you. Now we can speak. Yeah, please.
Yeah, in the Dr. G. Singh was asking, in that what we are doing, not only the wastewater, but also the total waste. So the one thing which we have started is, one is we are doing for our campus, in which all the waste, home household waste of the campus, is collected in the cart every day by the people. It goes to our vermicompost unit. It is being vermicomposted, and that vermicompost. Now we started that. Why not use the floral offering of the temples? The two temples, Lal Shiva temples. One is in the Baba Dham, Devghar. That's about away from here. So we took help of the local KBK and the temple administration. So whatever is floral offering is there, Sara ka Sara e cart me collect karke. और उसके बाद से वो चला जाता है केबीके को, दैट इज अबाउट 10 किलोमीटर अवे फ्रॉम देयर, एंड देयर इट इज वर्मिंग कंपोस्टेड. सिमिलर वी डिड फॉर दैट टेंपल व्हिच इज इन द नियर बाय टाउन मुजफ्फरपुर, दैट आल्सो बिग टेंपल. डेली वी सेंड वन ई कार्ड, कलेक्टेड द ऑल द ऑफरिंग, ब्रिंग इट एट अवर प्लेस एंड देन गेट इट वर्मिंग कंपोस्टेड, एंड विद दैट वी आर अर्निंग रेवेन्यू ऑफ 1 लाख रुपीज पर मंथ. we are spending only 400 rupees for the person who is going Delhi and bringing his CPP card, so we don't have any fuel expenditure. So this is one way also. Even the people of the Muzaffarpur, the ward councillor, were after me. कि साहब आप हमारे यहाँ से कूड़ा कलेक्ट कर लीजिए. मैंने कहा भाई आपका कूड़ा कलेक्ट करना हमारा वो नहीं है. हमें मंदिर से एक था कि मंदिर में जो होता है हम सुबह बहुत अच्छे से पवित्र मन से जाके ऑफर करके आते हैं फूल पत्ती, और शाम को कूड़े का ढेर बन के आप उठाकर उसे रोड के किनारे फेंकवा देते हैं. उससे बेहतर है कि हम खुद ले जाएंगे, हम वर्मी कंपोस्ट करेंगे. और मैंने पाया दैट इज ए नॉट ए घाटे का सौदा, और वी आर अर्निंग द रेवेन्यू फ्रॉम इट. So similar, I am planning that, no, we are even planning one project we have got. We are doing it for a village level, that all the village waste, including the cow dung, will be collected, converted in the vermicompost, compost. And we are linking with the Ujjwala Yojana, so that in the Ujjwala Yojana, they got the cylinder, but later on they are not refilling it properly, timely, because they feel here, bhai, kahan se usme paise lagenge. उपले बना लो, उपले से काम चल रहा है. I said, okay, you give your cow dung to us, don't make upla, we will be providing one cylinder every month. So that's how the system, they are very excited, and they are, that's how the system we are going to start. So my idea is, in the waste management, all the waste which is available in the village, let it convert it wherever it's possible. If you like it, few others also, we are working on the waste of this pigeon pea, and the maize cob stone. Again, because these two were being used as a fuel. With the Ujjwala coming in, now they are using LPG gas, and this is going to become a big menace. So that also, plus this wastewater. So if we are able to manage this wastewater and the waste, whatever is generated, we'll be able to make our villages clean. And this whole water system, then I started thinking that can we make our whole water system a sustainable one without any outside import of the water.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. I have a question from Dr. Pitam Chandra.
Hi, Dr. Srivastav. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, I was wondering that if we can somehow channelize the runoff during rainy season to ponds and lakes, will that somehow reduce our burden for groundwater recharge?
Problem is there that we have already choked all the ponds and the in the aquifer. What we are finding here, the aquifer study showed, we have got one unconfined aquifer at the depth of around 5 to 7 meters. And that aquifer is around 5 to 7 meters thick. Then after we have got a thick clay layer of about 20 meters. And then we have got the second aquifer. Mainly that second aquifer is being tapped. So what's happening, although you have got sufficient amount of the water at the, even above the surface, there's a water logging of 1 to 2 feet depth. But the lower aquifer, second aquifer, is not getting water percolated there sufficiently to refill it. So that aquifer is getting depleted year by year. And that's why even a state like Bihar, which is still in much more positive as far as you see from the other angle, is facing the water shortage every year, even for the drinking water during the summers.
Okay. Thank you.
Now, Mr. Rajesh, you've got a question you can ask. Rajesh?
Yeah,
you can ask the question.
Yes. Sir, how we can increase the recharging capacity in earthen pond? Suppose that we have constructed earthen pond for the recharging purpose, but how we can increase the recharging efficiency?
My idea is that if you want to recharge, you have to recharge the second aquifer. And for second aquifer, it has to be artificial recharge. Ponds are not allowing that much water to flow. The flow of water through that clay layer is so slow that even when the ponds are too big, only then you can do. You have to puncture that clay layer and send the water to the second aquifer. And for sending that water, it has to be clean. So 2%, the pond, normal in the pond condition, when it is normal filtration, the clay layer takes care of all the filtration. But that permeability of the clay layer is not able to recharge whatever recharge rate we are requiring. Actually, it was doing earlier when our recharge requirement was less. But now our recharge requirement, since we are pumping more, so our recharge requirement has increased. And that much money, that much water is not percolating through that clay layer in its natural course. So you have to puncture that clay layer and send the water directly to that aquifer, second aquifer. Maybe in few cases, it may be even the third aquifer.
Thank you. Mr. Ramesh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the meantime, I think Dr. K.
I got confused that you are calling me.
No. Sorry. Dr. K. N. Tiwari has a question. Dr. K. N. Tiwari, please.
Yeah. Actually, it's not a question. It's a Dr. Srivastava, what he was telling, recharge should be the emphasis so that we can have the groundwater reserve. Now, what I am actually putting here means government after government, whether UPA government or present government, what we have seen that MNDRS, you know, this Mahatma Gandhi Narega scheme, where majority of the work which is done for the earthwork basically for farming the check dams, for making, you know, water bodies, lot of work, you know, crores of rupees are being spent. But nothing has been, you know, so far it is reported how much it has benefited groundwater recharge. So point is this one, that it is being taken up by the different agencies. Can ISA tell that yes, these are the possible places where agriculture engineers should be involved in assessing these places and we should play our major role? So this is the actually point I want to put here.
No, here I would like to say, Dr. Tiwari, that the normal this pond system, it is, as I was telling earlier also, it is not able to, it is recharging the water, but the problem is the recharge is very slow because of that clay layer, and our demand is too high, and the recharge becomes, so it again becomes a balance sheet. So in the balance, the recharge is still not sufficient to make any significant difference in the availability of water, and that's happening with this all these mandiga works. And secondly, it is not designed properly so that you get the sufficient water.
Okay, thank you. I will take one question from Anushua Deep. Can you please ask your question, Anushua Deep? I think the attendees, when you raise your hand, I think I'd like to give the opportunity for all of you to ask questions. But I think if you don't ask, then I have to disable. Ramesh?
Can you hear me?
Who is speaking?
Go ahead, Ramesh.
Ramesh,
yeah,
please
go ahead.
Can you hear me?
Yes, Ramesh.
Okay, I think Dr. Srivastava, I like your idea of banking system. For net positive water kind of a use or water recharge. My question is, do we have a policy in India for each administered unit, like at a district level, district collector, if they can maintain a balance in terms of water harvesting, either water harvesting in terms of groundwater recharge or water harvesting in terms of surface storage? And they can be rewarded accordingly. It should be one of the annual activity. If that happens, I think then we can easily see if those policies are working. And India is totally self-sufficient in water, water resources.
Unfortunately, I would have loved that what you are telling us adopted. But till now, as I was telling that, there is no such policy that to make a district or any administrative unit as a water sustainable, water positive or water sustainable from the water side. The only thing, as I said, that every user group is politically very strong, and they are mainly interested that we should get this much water from where you are bringing it. Whether you are robbing the Peter and paying the Paul is your headache of the administration. We need water, and even if we waste it, don't ask us how, why we are wasting.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. No other questions?
Yes, I have.
Anything there? Yeah, please. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
Dr. Singh, yeah.
We have a district agriculture plan. We have a district irrigation plan. Can these plans be, can incorporate the suggestion like you are doing for overall water balance?
Yes.
I think you should try that because there is some groundwork already done, though most of the plans are hopeless.
Sir, I will not use the word software, but a program in Excel by which we could make it a irrigation plan for either block or by a district by using how much water we are pumping, and if you are pumping this much water, by how we can at least recharge like that much water. But unfortunately, they are very no taker of that in the government.
I think unless we do something like this scientific base based on the data, really, I don't think we'll make much headway.
Yeah, that's the basic. We have to take it up either at society level or some other level with the government so that the government listen to us. Because it's, to be honest, I will say that's not their mistake. They have been brought up in a particular mold. Pani ko bas aise hi manage karna hai. Pani itna wo nahi hai, bas supply side manage karni hai. They are very interested in how we are doing it in the balancing side, that how much we are recharging, how much we are using.
Thank you. I have some comment to make. I think the... Before that, Dr. Mayande want to ask.
I think, Dr. Srivastava, congratulations. I think you have touched very important area of water recharging. I am always concerned that the wastewater recycling is an area which is not addressed by the agriculture engineers adequately. And I was trying to make it at, when I was at PDKV, we made a model at Nagpur in jointly with National Engineering, Environmental Engineering Research Institute at Nagpur. And this model has shown that 98%, you have already visited it. 98% of the water can be utilized for irrigation. The wastewater can be utilized for irrigation, and we can grow all the vegetables with that irrigation water without any residual content. I think this is one area where I think we need to address more and more. And the another observation is that one of the project, ICR ACRIP project on micronutrients studied in the Pune sewage water, which is flowing through the river, Mulamitra River, up to 150 kilometers down the line, I think groundwater is polluted. And all the vegetables supplied to the town are grown on those groundwater. And I think this is being recycled. I think all the heavy metals and toxins are recycled into a human chain. I think these are a couple of concerns I think we in agricultural engineers should start addressing. I think either giving project to the PhD students or more specialized work in this. So I think you are actively working in the university now and you are the specialist in that. So I just thought of placing this issue before you. Thank you.
I had even put one more thing that if we can just filter it, this wastewater, and transport it to the nearby areas where we can grow the timber crops on with this irrigation, we can generate huge amount of the employment and green the hillocks. As Dr. Mayande was talking, if when you travel from Nagpur to Mumbai, I was traveling from Nagpur to Akola, then I saw that on the both sides you have got a hillock just to get out of the Nagpur town limit, and then after you will start seeing. If we get the wastewater transported there, use it by the micro irrigation, you can grow all along the timber crops there, which will green the those hillocks. So you will be managing the ecosystem, and with that you will get the employment opportunity. Plus, what Dr. Mayande was talking, will not allow that water to go to the rivers. polluting our whole system.
Thank you. I think we have been seeing so many webinars now. Many people are new in this. I think we are actually, the webinar was started 2.0 because many people felt that not enough work is done in agricultural sector by the scientists in India. For 40 years, my own experience, as we see also, there are so many state departments, so many times they dig the well, they put all type of water. None of the things really worked if I'm a farmer, if I talk. Because most of the problems lie with the departments and so many agencies involved and universities are having different concepts altogether working. There is no unity actually. So we try to make that. For example, we have taken the, we try to unite the people from industry and universities as well as research institutes, because I find all are excellent working, but then there is somewhere a link in between missing, because nobody talks about against his boss. Boss is always right. So that is very strongly built inside in the whole our system. So how to change it? So we make ISAE as a base, and a very ISAE is trying to do as a professional, like ASABI is a professional institution, like so many professional institutions existing in the world, which does excellent job. So we want to do it ISAE. So we started about 3-4 topics. We started with energy, like a lot of money has been spent on energy sector, especially when you go for biogas. You talked also a little bit about it. Then we come to solar pumps. We have spent about 32,000 crores on solar pumps, 2 lakh pumps installed. Another 70 lakh pumps are going to come. And then third one is we have built a lot of poly houses. But the question is asking really how many are working. The question is whether a farmer gets the benefit. So we have formed a tag group, technology application group, with the ISAE people, as well as we call the industry people. And it's doing excellent job now. Till now, we have presented 2 white papers on the preparation for a combined work on energy solution. We are going to have it in poly house also in the future. So we want to have this. I want to request all of you, just drop in a mail to ISAE or contact all the people you know here, that we want you experts to be in the tag team. This is nothing to do with any other institution. We want professionally to be, and probably ISAE would be an agency which can put up the proposals, because it's not biased against anyone. So an industry puts a proposal, they say it's biased, but I think we are all professionals. I think I would request you to come. Sorry for taking so much time for talking for the tag. We'll go move on to the second speaker now. It's an interesting topic. I think, as I told you, it's one of the topics that we would love to have now.